Hey folks, we are back inside for an update on our seedlings. So a few weeks ago I did a video where I set up an experiment to test out some worm castings that I bought at the store. You can see a link to that. Sorry for the giant finger. But there are a couple other parts in that series too you can check out. So I wanted to test that out on all of our peppers. So these are all with worm castings, and then the control group is here. Without worm castings. So, you take a look first at the jalapenos. You can see just how much bigger the leaves are on this one compared to the control. And this is all just visual observation. I'm not taking any measurements because it's pretty obvious in most cases. But not only the size of the leaves, but how many. This one is much further along, or at least a bit further along than the control. And so then we've got our bell peppers down here on the side, all with worm castings. And then this little guy in the back trying to catch up is without worm castings. So you can see too that there's, especially in this one, there's quite a bit of fungal growth on the top. And to me, it looks bad, but I can only assume with my limited knowledge at this point that it is not harmful, and in fact, quite the opposite. It is very beneficial for the plant, and you can see that's just quite a significant difference there between those two. And consistently with all of these, they are doing much better than the control group. The one that it's not as obvious is the green chilies in the front here. You can see though that this is with worm castings here, and this is without. The one without obviously looks much healthier, but there are some imperfections in this one that I noticed very early on. Some of the it's hard to do this looking through the camera. The first leaves that came out, actually these two irregular looking ones came out with the first set here before the true leaves started coming out. But there are more true leaves coming out than on this one. And it is like the others, it is a little bit further along in the growth process. So we also have, there's just a couple here in the front, bell peppers that didn't germinate. This one started and it shriveled up and died. So it sprouted okay and it was okay for a couple of days, and then it started to rot from the base near the soil and it fell over and shriveled up. Now the same thing happened with our Swiss chard over here. Yeah, the lettuce is absolutely out of control. We're getting compost tomorrow, so these are finally going to go out in the raised beds where they need to be so we can start harvesting, which we actually have been testing some of these out a little bit, taking some nibbles from the leaves. But anyway, the lettuce all did fine in here. These were all planted at the same time with worm castings, just at the same time as the peppers. The lettuce did fine. The Swiss chard, about 75% of them had the same problem as that pepper, and they shriveled up and died on the soil. So my theory is just that the ratio of worm castings that I added in was too high. As I said in the experiment video, I added one part of the worm castings to two parts of this sterilized seed starting mix. So about 33 1/3%. And I think that concentration, at least with the castings that I bought, was too high. You know, it might be different if you have a worm bin, if you're making your own worm castings, it's not going to be exactly the same. But so then when I planted everything else, all the tomatoes and basil and everything, I reduced the percentage of worm castings to about 20 to 25%, and I had no problems with any of these. They all came up just fine, nothing died. Of course, these are all, it's a completely different variety, so it's not really a basis for comparison to the Swiss chard. Again, all the lettuce did fine in there, but I would like to test out the Swiss chard again, planting some more of those, and reduce the amount of worm castings in there and see how well they do. So now that we have all of these wonderful, healthy looking plants, we can make a comparison to the very first batch that I started, where I did not sterilize the mix first, and I did not add any worm castings other than a light top dressing that I hoped it would maybe make a difference. I'm not sure if it did, but some of these are just barely hanging on. They definitely need to be transplanted out into the garden where they will be much happier and healthier. So we have more cauliflower and broccoli that I started at the same time with these. And the good news is that they are doing much happier now that I have potted them up and followed the same procedure as I did with the rest of these. So they are much happier now. It took two batches of sterilizing the starting mix for these, and even still I ran out by the time I got to this one, so at least I could leave this for a comparison to how well these are doing. Part of that is that they have more room for root growth, but I firmly believe at this point the addition of the worm castings makes a huge difference for those. So yeah, my conclusion with all this is that the worm castings really do help. Any gardener out there will tell you the same thing. I just wanted to try this for myself to see the results and draw my own conclusions and make a video to put up on YouTube for anyone who's watching this. And thank you for doing so. If this video was helpful to you, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And be sure to subscribe with the button below for more videos. Thanks. I'll see you next time.